Hello everyone, welcome to tutorial 52 of our Golang course. In the last tutorial, we looked at sentinel errors and wrapping of errors. At this point, I should mention that if sentinel error is wrapped in another error, you won't be able to use simple equal to comparison to check if the sentinel error is in the error chain. This is where the two functions errors.Is and errors.As come into play. So let's have a look at them in this lesson. First, let us look at errors.is function. The errors.is function accepts two parameters. The first is the error we are checking, and the second is the instance of the error we are checking against. For example, a sentinel error, which is a variable or instance of an error. The function signature is as follows. Func is error target returning a bool if the error instance matches the target. The error.is function will go through the error chain, also known as the error tree, unwrapping errors and comparing errors in the chain with the target instance. By implementing your own is error returning a bool method, you can customize the error is behavior. For example, you can allow matching non-equal instances of error. But again, these are more advanced topics and you should not worry about them if you are starting with Go. Also, you would have to rarely use them for your day-to-day programming. Let's now look at an example. In here, first I'm going to create a custom error so that we can create a sentinel error of unknown. So here I created a custom error which has only one field, which is the message. Now let's implement the error method to satisfy the error interface. So let's now just return the message. So now we have implemented the error interface. Now let's create a sentinel error. Var, the name of sentinel error usually starts with err. So this here is our first sentinel error. Now let's create a function that returns this sentinel error. Inside it, let us return error, first error. Now inside our main, let's call some function. fmt println error. Go run main.go and as you can see, first error was printed to the console. So our custom error is working as expected. In cases when we want to check if the function is returning a sentinel error or some other random error, we can use the errors function. Let's see how this works. If error not is equal to nil, and then error is the error that we get and the target error, which is err first error. Fmt println sentinel error found. Let's run our program to verify the behavior. Go run main.go and as you can see, this evaluated to true, which is why we are seeing sentinel error found. Now let's try to wrap our error return from some function. And then I'm providing the sentinel error to be wrapped. Let's try again to run our program and see the behavior. And as you can see, it still prints sentinel error found because error is will go through the chain of errors or all the wrapped errors to find this instance of error. If found, it will return true, which is what we are getting here. Let's now see another example of using errors. This time, I am going to use a sentinel error from io.fs package. So as you can see in the example here, what we are doing is we are using the OS package to open a non-existing file. We are then checking if the error is error not exist, which is a sentinel error in the fs package. As you can see, it is defined as a variable error not exist, which indicates that the file does not exist. Let's run our program to verify if it's working as expected. And as you can see, the open function returned a sentinel error, which is fs.errornotexist. And as such, we were able to print file does not exist. So this is basically how you would use sentinel errors in your code to indicate a special event and then handle it accordingly in your code like we did here. Now let's look at errors function. The errors function accepts two parameters. First is the error itself, and the second is a non-nil pointer to either a type that implements error or to any interface type. This is the signature of the function. It accepts error and then the target of any type, returning bool. Errors function finds the first error in the error chain or the tree that matches the target type. If one is found, it sets the target to the error value, otherwise it returns false. A custom error implementation matches target if the error's concrete value in the custom error is assignable to the value pointed by the target, or if the error has a method as which accepts an interface type and returns a bool, such that as returns true. So this is basically how you will customize the behavior of as if you have your own custom error. In this case, as method that you are writing is responsible for setting the target. Please note, errors.as will panic If target is not a null nin pointer to either a type that implements error or to any interface type. Let us look at an example for the same. I am again going to use a custom error. I have the custom error struct which I am using to implement the error interface, and inside it I am just returning the message. Our sum function here returns a custom error. Now, in your Go code, sometimes you need to access values on the custom error or fields on the custom error. For example, I can add status, which is an int here, and then do status 400. In some cases, you may want to access the status of the custom error. This is where ErrorAs comes into play. So let's create our main function here. In the main function, let's call sum function. We get the error. Now, to get the target error, let's create a variable of custom error type, and then we can use the errors.as function to get the custom error from the error chain. So this is how you would use errors. We are passing a pointer to that variable, and then we can use custom error inside the if block. Let's now run our program to verify the behavior. And as you can see, extracted custom error was called. Now, I can also do status, which is the field you may want to access. Go run main.go, and as you can see, status was printed to the console. So this is how you would use error.as to extract the custom error information from the provided error. Let's now look at another example of doing so. Here, I'm using the path error from sslib, which has op string path and error. And as you can see, it implements the error interface along with unwrap. In errors.s, I am getting the error by passing the pointer to the variable, and inside it, I'm just accessing the path field on the path error, which is returned from when we call os.open. Now let's run our program to see if we can access the path from the error. And as such, we can access the path. If you want, we can also access other fields on this error, like op. So running our program, and as you can see, op, which is open, was printed to the console. So this is basically how you would use error.as to get an error and then read the fields from that error. Let's now summarize everything we have learned in this lesson. We looked at functions exported by the error standard lib package, which are error.is and error.as. Both are used to compare errors and work with wrapped errors as well. The errors function is used to check against an instance of error like sentinel errors, as we saw in the example, while the errors function is used to check for type of the error and get the matching error type from the error chain, which further can be used to access values on the error or fields on the custom error. That's it for the lesson. I hope you enjoyed it. Please feel free to leave a comment under the video if you have any questions, or reach out to our Discord server. Thanks for watching. Happy coding.